Story with Stalin and the chicken. I don't know if it happened. You know, it's funny that sometimes the people who believe just about anything, they have these moments where all of a sudden they want to prove to everybody that they are thinkers. And they say,
well, how do we know that Stalin really did that? And what is your source, man?
So, my source, I have no source. My source is an internet meme. I'm going with the flow. I'm doing what people are doing. You see, when you post too much research, people tune out. They don't want that. Most people do. I've realized it. So my blog is for research. My YouTube channel contains some research, but I'm doing my best to clear my mind off of any research before I get on the air, if you will. Because I know many of you have other things on your minds. I'm understanding that. You see, I am one track minded. Well, I have many different tracks, but there are tracks I'm on, and there are tracks that I don't even want to get close to. And whether or not the story is true doesn't make a difference to me, because it could have happened. And what matters about the story is that the, you know, what we learn from it, and the sad reality, because a couple of you have been driving yourselves crazy trying to reach people and teach people about various things that are important to you and me. But are they important to others? Well, don't make other people so much more important than they make themselves. You know, everything sort of works its way out. I can see that now. Because people, you see, the people who were screaming, die Jews in Germany, they were known as honorable people before. Okay? They were known as good people. Oh, these are the people that need help. They need this, they need that. You see, you never know what a person is capable of in terms of stupidity or evil until they have a chance. You know, think about it like this. You put this person that you're trying to reach and teach into a wonderful position. They have power over a lot of people. What do you think they would do? Or how do you think the positive energy that you give to them, they're going to pass on to others? Or will they? Because a lot of people don't. And I've seen that in walks of life that I don't plan to get into ever, you know, in terms of revealing to you these details. But so I keep it very general. And that's when it's very nice for me to see something that I can actually use that reflects certain experiences that I have made. They have completely changed my life in the last 2 years due to a position I was in where I actually reached a lot of people and then stopped reaching them. It was by choice that I disconnected. And I wanted to see what will people do with the information you provide them with. People who followed you, people who said, please, I need more info. Talk about this, let me know that. Okay. What do they do when you say, I need to disconnect? Some wait for you. Most will find somebody else to follow. That means they only followed me. They didn't do this out of their own intuitive desires to learn something. You know what I mean? And they haven't passed on anything. They are now in copy groups where fake information, you know, is run down their necks, but they are addicted to it. That's all they're able to do right now. So they were never the kind of people that I like to have close to me, because they are, everything is sort of circular. You have your inner circle. These are people where we are just like the same mind. And then there are people a little bit around, and then there are people that are far away. Yes, they can be they're the types of people that like to watch TV normally, you know what I mean? And You know, I honestly, like, these experiences, they have shown me that I was completely wrong when it came to looking for the good in humanity, thinking if people only had a fairer chance in life, etc. It's no, there are certain traits that I am now convinced certain people just have that are not beneficial for them and are not going to be beneficial for those who spend their energy changing their lives for them, thinking they will pass that energy on. No, it'll make them lazy, it'll make them, you know, I learned that now, I realize that now more than anything. Okay, Stalin once ripped all the feathers off a live chicken as a result to his followers. I mean, anybody who has empathy, I understand that it's gonna be hard to even listen to this, but I want to get through this one. He then said the chicken, well, anyways, the more I don't wanna go. So he basically mutilated this chicken and then set it away somewhere. When Stalin began to toss some bits of wheat towards the chicken, it followed him around. You see, he tortured this chicken and then gave him some corns, and suddenly the chicken came back and followed him around. So he said to his followers, this is how easy it is to govern stupid people. They will follow you no matter how much pain you cause them, as long as you throw them a little worthless treat once in a while. So this is not really me trying, this is me reaching the few of you. I'm now thinking only about a few of you who I know have been wasting your time and energy. And all I can tell you is, man, don't make that mistake that I made, because you're gonna be also, a lot of people, they will actually get angry with you because they believe you owe them something. I mean, you see people sometimes commenting on my channel, well, I'm not gonna watch if you don't have better sound, etc., etc. As if I'm these people, these are not the type of people that I'm here to reach. I am not here to, I'm here to connect with the like-minded. I am not here to change anybody's mind about anything, because it simply will not work. And why this will not work, this is, hey, I'm not gonna get into that, into theories, etc. I'm not gonna worry what other people do. I'm here to reach the ones who, you know, are interested not in what most people pay attention to, but actually in what is worth paying some attention to.